That's actually how you brainwash someone. Continuously hearing the same thing over and over, that's a form of brainwashing.
So you think that Christians are being brainwashed?
I think for the most part we have been, and I think it started.
The point that's being made in this book is that these reverends send subliminal messages that we are not in power. Yeah. Because it says, no, you're not the problem, the devil is the problem.
Isn't it the evil forces that is causing you to do what you do?
Not necessarily.
What is it, the good forces that's causing you to do it?
Well, we don't even want to get started on how I believe in the devil and all the type of stuff like that.
If it's not the good forces, it's got to be the evil forces. It's only good or evil or neutral.
We need this institution to gather and to come together and grow.
So what are you saying? Church limit black progress or not?
What she was saying is, my point I'm getting is that the
preachers... I don't care what she's saying.
My point is, the preachers, they more or less, they teach, but they talk about the same thing over and over again, what was done in the Bible. If they could talk about more or less economical values and talk about investments, they have a lot of power there. They have those people's attention right there.
That's right.
They can tell them, we as a community should be doing this.
Because really we're talking about economic development. We're talking about people learning, people investing, people being involved in the political process.
I think one of the things that he's talking about...
Why do you define black progress? Do you agree with this? The church is somehow stopping black people from acquiring this knowledge and progressing economically and politically?
We've been taught that the man should lead us. You know, we've been taught this, so I think that we're buying, most women are buying this at any cost.
You don't think that's true that the man should be the leader?
I think if you want the man to lead you, lead you. I don't think everybody, just because you are a male or you a man, you should be leading somebody. I think you have to be qualified for it, because somebody leading you can lead you astray.
What makes you qualified to be a preacher?
I don't know. I don't know what makes someone qualified to be a preacher, but I believe that...
What about it, John? So you don't agree with what he just said?
I don't think he necessarily disagreed with it. He brought it up.
That was one of his main driving points.
Do you believe that there should be entertainment in the church?
I think.
Cause you agree that there is an entertainment element.
And I believe it's okay. It's worshiping. It's praising. I don't have a problem with that. I don't have a problem with that. The only problem I have is what the minister feed his flock and how he does it. That's the only thing that concerns me. Like I said, I believe in the foundation of the church. I believe in the Baptist church. But I believe that the ministers need to re-educate themselves on educating their flock.
Do you agree with what he said, that it's okay to dance and sing? No, a minute ago you said it wasn't cool.
No, I was saying, I understand what he's saying. Now, do I think it's something we should be doing? No.
You guys give a thumbs up or thumbs down to the book. John, go. Thumbs up or thumbs down?
I enjoyed the book.
Thumbs up or thumbs down?
Thumbs up.
Kim?
Two thumbs up.
Tony?
Thumbs up, and I think a lot of ministers today should read this book. If you go to a church, bad is for your minister.
Yeah, basically.
That's right.
Yeah.
Bad is for your minister. Yeah. That's right.
I'll give the book a thumbs up. I thought the book was very good, very enlightening, had some good stuff to say.